my presentation in the 8th International Congress of EBRMA in Palma de Mallorca was dedicated to give an overview of the current techniques of fertility preservation in women with malignancies. Although both techniques can be used also for what we call today elective fertility preservation, which means women who have no disease and want to preserve fertility. So the two techniques are either ovarian tissue cryopreservation and subsequent transplantation, or oocyte vitrification. So I reviewed how oocyte tissue cryopreservation, although it's feasible, and we have done more than 50 transplantations already, is associated with still many questions to be answered. And the most important one is the probability that after transplantation, we are transferring back into the woman malignant cells. Because many of these women were treated when they were young and they suffer from hematological diseases, and these hematological diseases may carry malignant cells into the ovarian tissue that when transplanted again may be very dangerous for the woman. However, oocyte cryopreservation or vitrification is a different story. Oocyte vitrification has developed together with vitrification of oocytes and embryo in vitro fertilization, so there is a lot of experience around the world, and we are not doing anything different in women with cancer. It's the same technique, the same approach, and the only concerns are the facts that they may not be stimulated so high in order to avoid high estrogen levels, because this, in theory, it might be detrimental for their cancer. But this has been solved. And for the rest, I think that oocyte vitrification is more advantageous than ovarian cortex transplantation. Better outcomes, easy to do, more reproducible, etc., etc. So this is the bottom line of my presentation. Both techniques work. The only advantage of ovarian cortex might be that it can be used in prepubertal girls, but for the rest, although both work, I think that oocyte vitrification is already in place. Everybody is using it around the world, and the American Society for Cancer in their guidelines of 2018 still considers cortex or tissue preservation an experimental technique, whereas oocyte vitrification is totally accepted and introduced in the clinical practice.